In this session, what I wanted to do is to kind of go over your assignment dealing with carbohydrate counting. The assignment is called My Food Plan because what we're going to be using is a kind of a universal planning document that can be used and is used in even different countries. It's very general. It may be not as specific as what you might find at a hospital in this country, whatever, but it's a very general one. That would give you the idea of how to do carbohydrate counting. You should understand that diabetics need to really watch their carbohydrates. That's the most important thing because the carbohydrates are going to turn into sugars and they're going to be the most important consideration in your diet is what turns into sugars. Not so much proteins, not so much fat, but the carbohydrate that you take in, which is going to be broken down into sugars, get into your bloodstream, influence insulin levels, and really wreak havoc with your blood sugar regulation. So what a diabetic is sent home with and what they're trained to do is to look at their carbohydrates and do a process called carbohydrate counting. So I just wanted to give you a little bit of information on that and have you actually do a simulated carbohydrate counting exercise that would teach you how it's done and kind of give you a little indication or maybe even empathy for someone that has to watch their carbohydrates and what they have to think about day in and day out. So I wanted to teach you about that. So the first thing I want you to do is you're going to be looking at an upload. You should have downloaded and copied off your assignment page and instructions. From that information, then let's go through and teach you what you're actually going to have to document and what you're going to have to actually upload for me. So the first thing you want to do, and it's kind of simulating the idea that a diabetic is going to come in and to a dietitian or to a healthcare provider and they're going to be newly diagnosed as a diabetic, and what you're going to do and what the healthcare provider would do is look at their intake and try to come up with a plan that they could take home with them that would help them to do their carbohydrate counting. So the first thing that I would like you to do is to determine choices. Now in this carbohydrate counting, they label the amount of carbohydrate servings as choices. And so you'll have carb choices, you'll have protein choices, and you'll have fat choices. So they don't really call them servings, they call them choices. So what you're going to do is look at your 3-day average page that you did for your diet study. So you're going to need that. And you're going to need to look at your 3-day average, look at the intake and DRI goals compared page, and then look at the column that says DRI. Now this is going to be your goals. All right, and this is really what you're going. You would send the diabetic home with person is the goals that they need to meet for that. And so, for our purposes, on your 3-day average page, what you'll notice is that they actually give you a range. You know, for example, the carbohydrates 296 to 428. Well, what we're going to determine, and I noticed I have a mistake on there already, it should be 58%, because if you remember from your diet study, you needed 58% calories, carbohydrates. I think the calculation is correct, but what we're going to use is those percentages. So what I did was took the 2635 calories times 0.58, which is 58%, divide that by 4 calories per gram, and what that gives you is 382 grams that our goal is for carbohydrates, and then the 30% for lipids and so forth. So what you would do then is determine your carbohydrate choices. So take your carb grams, and you're going to divide that by 15. Now I'll explain later why it's 15, but basically, for now, one choice of carbohydrate is represented by 15 grams. So for every 15 grams of carbs you eat, that would equal one choice. So we're going to have to determine how many choices. So in our example here, we had 382, so it'd be 382 divided by 15 would give us a certain amount of choices. The proteins are going to be 7, so for every 7 grams, or basically 1 ounce, for every ounce of protein we intake, for every 7 ounces, 7 grams, and that's going to be one choice, and then fats are going to be 5. So on this slide, I kind of represented that, except again, the 48% at the end of the arrow should be 58%. Sorry about that. And then we have the 30 and 12, so our fats 30% and 12%. So that's kind of what we did with our diet study and did that. So you can determine your grams and then determine your choices. By divide making those divide numbers. Then what I want you to do is look at your current choices, which would be based on your intake. So we're going to do the same thing, but we're going to look at the intake column, and you're going to have those grams, and so they're set. So you just divide the carbs by 15, the protein by 7, and the fat by 5, and that'll give you the number of choices you have now. So this would be kind of simulating that this person who has been newly diagnosed as a diabetic, and you look at their diet, and this is what they're eating now. And hopefully, you'll see that there's going to be some differences between what your goals are and what your actual intake is. So, we're kind of forcing you to become a diabetic. So, what you would do then is just kind of compare those. So on a separate piece of paper, what I'm asking you to do is show your calculations and show me that you understand that the carbohydrates divide by 15 and so forth. And just put that into a Word document, or you could put that on an Excel sheet or however, and then you'd want to save that, and then you're going to upload that and save it to the assignment page. And then, I'll be able to access that and make sure. So again, on a separate piece of paper, as a Word document or as an Excel file, whatever you want, save that, and then you're going to upload that into your information. So, but like I mentioned, our food plan is going to be based on our goals. So it'll be the DRI column. So look at the DRI column, the first one you did, and those choices, and we're going to use those. And so go into the website, and on your assignment, click on the My Food Plan worksheet. And you'll notice also on that sheet, you have the PowerPoints, which you're looking at now, and the My Food Plan instructions. But when you click on the worksheet, what you'll end up is looking at a page that looks like this. And so it's the My Food Plan. You're able to write on that page, and so you can put your name in and everything. So it'll say, you'll notice in the upper left-hand column, it'll say that you're able to write on that. So type in your name, type in the date and everything.